Earlier this year, I began the 88th Armory with the idea of adding some variety to my, and maybe some viewers' arsenals by looking at weapon and Warframe builds that can work for the mid-game where we play a lot of Warframe's experience and see what might make it into or close to the endgame. What I found in doing this was that I want to put everything on the table. Warframe is a game most often played in the mid-tier of its difficulty. This means facing enemies that are somewhere from 25 to 45 in level, give or take 5 levels. But what I found in attempting to point out in some of these weapons and builds that I enjoy in my mid-game play was that there are tons more to be had than even I thought. What we're looking for here is more variety, more fun in our Warframe experience. I still want to focus on more weapons, builds, and combinations for the mid-tier of the game where we often have a lot of our play, but I want to put all options on the table to find these elements of enjoyment through diversity, which is a lot of what Warframe has to offer. I'm Scott from Ramble Entertainment, and this is the new version of Season 1 of the 88th Armory. Let's find our fun, let's find our variety. So the final frame that I want to talk about for the Season 1 of the 88th Armory is Atlas, or more specifically, the build, AOE Atlas, because I think there is this stigma that Atlas doesn't do AOE. It kind of makes him unalluring. He doesn't equip a weapon like Excalibur or Vara do. Makes him a bit confusing. His survivability might be a bit hard to find. So I want to talk about these things. I don't see a lot of Atlas players personally. I don't think my friends see a lot of Atlas players. So again, something that could potentially be fun to talk to. Before we get into it, as I mentioned, State of the Frame and the 88th Armory Season 1 are coming to a close. I'm already technically on a bit of a break from Warframe. The reason for this is because breaks are healthy. The last time I took a break from Warframe, I actually came back to the game about 2.5 months later, maybe 3 months later, and when I was looking over my builds, they were kind of no longer sacred, and I was able to find even better ways to function within the game, and I think that's helpful too. And so, really, what I one of the things that I can highlight off that fact is the fact that is the idea that I came back, and when I had left, Atlas was kind of I was still a bit confuzzled by how Atlas survives. At first I thought, like, okay, vitality and steel fiber, and that'll keep me up and keep me going. But really, I would still go down a number of times, and I was just like, I'm not getting this. And then when I came back, I was looking at a lot of frames with quick thinking, not just Trinity, not just Volt, not just Nova. I was trying it with all frames, and when I came to Atlas, I thought, what the heck? And so I put it on, and it made sense. Atlas has a large energy pool. He is basically an energy tank, not like Samus Aran, energy tank from Metroid, but he has a lot of energy, not just for his abilities, but when combined with Zenuric, it becomes this force for his survival, not just his power of attack, where basically his armor helps to protect that energy, as well as Quick Thinking's energy efficiency. So, and his moves aren't really that costly, especially when you're comboing his fist attacks. So a lot of this can really help when it comes to how does this frame survive. You're doubling down on Prime Flow. Now, Flow would probably be fine. A non-maxed Prime Flow would be even better. But of course, a max Prime Flow, you're getting full survivability, full complement of energy to utilize for your attacks and abilities. And so I think that's kind of one of the things of one of these confusing notions behind Atlas out of the way. And I think one of the other confusing notions is that he's not an AoE frame. He is an AoE frame. It's just that the AoE travels with him, so the AoE can move all about the field, but it just takes time as he moves about the field. However, the AoE can also be separated from him through the rumblers, so the rumblers can go out about the field and help in kind of this different AoE style. I think this notion existed before Mogamu even said it, but Mogamu did the, you know, like, top Warframes video. Vote for your Warframes, and Atlas came in at 28. And if memory serves correctly, he said that Atlas likely isn't very popular because he's a bit more complex and not an AoE frame. It's just that, and this will be a lot more highlighted in the final segment of the video. Oh, I accidentally turned into a Tenno and jumped around for a bit. But I mean, even here you're seeing that with a single fist, we're hitting multiple enemies, getting death blows on multiple enemies. And when it comes to his AoE style, it's just different. And that's why I wanted to show it off here. So with all of that in mind, let's go ahead and get into the builds for Atlas, AoE Atlas, and for the Furex, which is the weapon, a weapon that I simply dedicate to Atlas and don't really equip with any other Warframes. So as I mentioned, what we have here is our AoE Atlas style, relying on quick thinking. I use quick thinking and prime flow for my survivability for all my Atlas builds. And then beyond quick thinking, what we have is, much like with Inaros, our adjustment between range and strength comes from different overextendeds. Basically, you can take a rank 3 overextended like I do in this build and get up to 205% with stretch, and or you can switch out that overextended for even a max rank overextended, get about $145. I know this one. $145 strength. I did it without looking, I swear. And then you can have 235 range. I would not put a Cunning Drift on. I don't think it really adds that much more range that it's worth it. Instead, I would focus more on the damage. And that range gets you up to about 13 meters of range around each punch, or 13 meters around the uppercut. I think it is 6, 8, and then 15 is the max, so that would be about, still near 6, roughly 7, and then roughly 13 around that uppercut, but each one comes in really fast, so there's a lot of opportunity again for that range. Also, range is added through the rumblers who go out and have their presence elsewhere. I think these are, you know, kind of important notions of how one is effective with their AoE. There are different variations in how we use AoE, and of course Transient Fortitude and Intensify for your strength, and Streamline is really all the efficiency you need with that kind of a build. Now, when it comes to a melee weapon like the Furex, or as I use the Kugake for Atlas's, to complement Atlas's fists, or his, what's that called? Tectonics? I think it's Tectonics. Basically, I don't do anything beyond a whole bunch of damage. The reason for this, I've tested combo counter, I've tested range, I've tested, speed, and really, I think that the only things worth doing are status and damage. And that's it, and really, when you do that, you get damage. And that's all that boils down to. Wiki doesn't have too many answers on either of those, and I think the reason is because that if there is any kind of detail to be had there, it's so minute, whether that's through strength, through speed or range, that it is almost imperceptible. So really, again, just go for pure damage. And then, throw some fists. So with all of that in mind, let's go ahead and talk about some positive and negatives behind the builds, behind Atlas, and then of course we'll play some footage, and then we'll probably go. This will be a shorter one because it is Atlas. That there are likely to be some ribbons for the melee weapons, but ribbons and affecting
Warframe aren't really a clear thing yet in my mind. I have done a bit of testing, have seen some anomalies, is really all I'll say about that. But beyond that, I don't think that there is too much more to be said. So, as I said,
final footage. Ho!
What happened there? Oh god, why is there a black box? Oh god, get rid of it. Oh god, get rid of it. So, I think with all of this in mind, one of the best ways to finish up in my mind is an infested excavation. Now, impact damage does suffer under infested conditions, so like infested flesh, there are armor types. However, even with all of that, you can really start to see the AOE taking effect with Atlas's fists, and that's really what I wanted to highlight here. I wanted to show gameplay where enemies cluster and really highlight Atlas's ability to control areas and do a lot of damage. AOE Atlas is real. So beyond the shorter range of each AOE strike, I think it is worth noting that, as a negative, Atlas is very survivable. Like, he's a complex frame because of what it takes to find his survivability. I think that a lot of people don't take to quick thinking so easily, especially for frames that don't restore their own energy or that are, you know, like these heavy armor frames. It's a bit counterintuitive to want to go quick thinking. But really, again, when I was ready to just throw away all my builds and start fresh, it made sense. And so, again, I think that is one of the things that holds people back, is just like, how does this terrain work? It's a bit obtuse. But beyond that, I think that Atlas is pretty damn well-rounded. Typically, this isn't a show. I said this with the Convectrix, and here I am in the next episode doing this, but I can't help it because what are they called? I have his abilities pulled up here. So, yeah, I really should be remembering this shit. Also, it wasn't Tectonics earlier. That is what I was looking for. The Tectonics is the wall he puts up. Instead, I was talking about Landslide, where he does the punches with the uppercut cut at the end. The Tectonics is really what I want to focus on. You can clear a mod slot for Tectonics. I wouldn't go with a range build when I'm using Tectonics. I would just sacrifice a bit of strength, probably intensify for the augment that allows you to create 3 Tectonic walls. But beyond that augment, I don't think Tectonics is a fully realized ability. Again, typically I don't want to talk about like, oh, this is how we're going to make this frame better. Yeah, get them, community. Get DE! No, you know, like, I think a lot of things function well within the game, which is why I do videos about the game, because I really wouldn't get behind a game that I don't think functions well. And so, yeah, Tectonics, I think, either needs to kind of get the Volt treatment where it gets bigger, like Volt's shield did, or maybe this one could just be a bit of a blanket rework where the augment still allows you to place 3 walls. Look at all that AoE, I'm loving this. And I was even playing it, and I'm loving it more right now. So, yeah, I'm thinking Tectonics could just use a bit of bluff, but beyond that, I personally find Atlas to be pretty well-rounded. And one of the things I haven't mentioned, because I typically don't use it, but even works well with this style of build, is the ability to use the Petrify, this Gorgon's Eye style, the Medusa kind of style petrifying. It is a wonderful control maneuver, and even before I took my break, my original break from Warframe, that was one of my kind of methods for this is how I keep Atlas alive. I just control the shit out of everything, because around 235 range and still getting up to 135 percent strength, you'll basically petrify everything within 1 second, and then that does damage over time, which is also cool. So with this range style Atlas, you actually have a pretty well-rounded frame when it comes to all 4 of his abilities, and he hits super hard too. I don't know if you've been watching some of those numbers, but he'll get some really insane white numbers popping up. So especially if you go with a strength build where you go strength, basically super high duration, super high strength, incredibly low range, and then, of course, standard efficiency, 130. You'll just get insanely huge numbers. I've gotten hundreds of thousands on single fist throws, not even the uppercut. So, yeah, just some cool things to keep in mind about Atlas. Maybe some other time we'll look at that kind of standard build where you're reducing range instead. But with all of this in mind, let's go ahead and let the background footage play. Beyond a lot of detail of what we said earlier, about like all the positives and the few negatives that come with this, I think that one of the things really worth noting here is that my team, these randoms that I jumped in with on Harrakhan, is that they deploy another extractor, and I'm basically covering D by myself. I'm basically covering this extractor entirely by myself with my rumblers, with my tectonic plate, with my fists, and I mean, to each their own. Maybe they were leveling, maybe they were doing their thing, but with a fully powered up Atlas, we're holding our own against the infested, and I think that that is definitely worth a highlight here. And there goes the extractor. Extractor is destroyed, and our excavator is destroyed, and yeah, that's I think that's important, because not every frame has this kind of breadth of abilities that allows them to hold their own when defending an excavator. And I'm not saying, you know, the enemies are that high of level. Again, what we really like to demonstrate here is the mid-range of gameplay, because there is a lot of opportunity to enjoy variety here in the mid-range of our Warframe experience. Beyond all of this, I don't really think there is much more to say as far as a Riven for the Furax goes, because often we kind of do this Riven theorizing what Rivens could look like for our weapons. Again, I kind of talked about how, like, I've seen some anomalies when playing with Rivens when it comes to how they combine with Warframe abilities. But I don't know if they'll have any effect on Atlas, to be frank. If you get some strength, you know, on a Riven mod, and you want to give it a shot, you know, definitely do that testing, but I just don't think Riven mods are meant to function with Warframe abilities. These kind of single target, even though this one's an AOE ability, these mostly single target, high damage single target Warframes, already do incredibly high damage. I don't think it would be kind of fair to allow them to benefit from Rivens where other Warframes cannot. So with all that in mind, I think we're about done here. Again, season 1 is coming to a close. just because, as I mentioned, early in my Warframe lifetime, I took a break and came back and played all kinds of different games, and kind of got me thinking differently and allowed me to come back and really appreciate what I have with the game, and allowed me to... my builds were no longer sacred. I think that's another important point. So I'm already kind of eager for when I'll get back to Warframe, which will probably be about March or April, because things have gotten so delayed because of the new equipment, blah, blah, blah. And so with all of that in mind, yeah, probably shoot for mid-March, early April to get back to things, but I don't like to set deadlines because, this isn't something that pays. This is a hobby, so... I have a job and things might change with all of that stuff. Things might change with my health, because health has been a problem throughout the past 4 years and with my endeavors. But nonetheless, I will strive to return in a decently timely manner. Again, thanks for watching and thanks for subscribing. As always, if you like what we had to do here, do the thing, and I'll see you in the next episode. Ta-ta!